Hello, in this video, we will make this mind map of clinical uses of opioids. Let's get started. Broadly speaking, opioids are used in analgesia, for relief of anxiety and apprehension, during anesthesia, in acute left ventricular failure or pulmonary edema, shivering, diarrhea, and dry cough. Let's dig deep into analgesia first. Opioid group of drugs are used for moderate to severe pain, for example postoperatively, for renal colic, burns, traumatic pain, ischemic pain like myocardial infarction, cancer pain, and in obstetric analgesia. When used during labor, morphine may cross placenta and cause respiratory depression in fetus. This is less with meperidine. For milder pain like headache and arthralgia, NSAIDs are preferred. If they are not effective, opioids like codeine, tapentadol, and tramadol are used. They can be used alone or in combination with paracetamol. For more severe and longer lasting pain, NSAIDs are given along with opioids. This combination is supra-additive and decreases required dose of opioids. So this was about different degrees of pain. Now there is a technique called patient controlled analgesia. In this, rate of infusion is controlled by patient. For this, patient needs to be trained, but chances of dependence is less with this. Fentanyl is commonly used for this. When using opioids for pain, you need to keep some general points in mind. Let's see them. Opioids provide only symptomatic relief in pain. They do not affect basic pathology. And pain is valuable for diagnosis. So they should not be used unless proper assessment has been done. With opioids, dull, poorly localized visceral pain is relieved better than sharply defined somatic pain. Pain arising from peripheral pain receptors is relieved better than neuropathic pain. Neuropathic pain is treated better with pregabalin or amitriptyline. Cancer and other terminal illness may require continuous use of opioids. This increases chances of development of tolerance and dependence. However, this should not limit best care and quality of life of the patient. So this was all about use as analgesic. Now let's see use of opioids in anesthetic practice. They can be used as pre-anesthetic medication because of their sedative and analgesic property. For this, morphine or pethidine may be used. For neural left anesthesia, neural left analgesia, and balanced anesthesia, fentanyl is used. To produce segmental anesthesia, opioids can be given by intrathecal or epidural injection. This route decreases risk of respiratory depression and other side effects. However, ascent of drug through subarachnoid space to respiratory center can cause respiratory depression. This is more frequent with morphine. Fentanyl, on the other hand, shows greater uptake by nerves at the site of injection. So there is less respiratory depression. So these were the uses in anesthetic practices. Coming to relief of anxiety and apprehension. For this, morphine is used. This is beneficial in patients with internal bleeding and myocardial infarction. So yes, in myocardial infarction, it benefits in two ways. By relieving pain, as well as relieving anxiety and apprehension, which suppresses reflex overactivity and thereby prevent worsening of the condition. So these were the uses related to central nervous system. Let's move outside the CNS. Use in acute left ventricular failure or pulmonary edema. For this, again morphine is used. It shifts blood from pulmonary to systemic circulation, which relieves pulmonary congestion and edema. It reduces venous tone, which decreases preload. Decrease in peripheral resistance decreases afterload. Depression of respiratory center allays air hunger. It calms the patient, which decreases sympathetic stimulation and decreases cardiac work. For shivering, meperidine can be used. It apparently acts through a subtype of alpha-2 receptor. For antidiarrheal property, codeine has been used in colostomy to check diarrhea and improve consistency of stool. Opioids commonly used for diarrhea are diphenoxylate and loperamide. For dry cough, drugs used are codeine, ethyl morphine and fulcodine. All these drugs, along with those used for diarrhea, are non-addictive and non-analgesic. So these are the uses of opioids. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.